Hello everyone, we are back with some more Mutant Year Zero, and I played back until the correct point where we're going to Hammond's cabin. We're not gonna get ambushed by fucking ghouls, whatever they're called. We're not gonna get butt-raped and killed. Let's do this. This run is so much better. I've actually, like, since I kind of know what to expect now, I've been like, oh my god, it's so much better. You guys are gonna love it. Dude, my duck is fucking kitted out, man. Look at this guy. Look at him. Look at his gear. Huh? Huh? Look at this. Look at this. Look at this. He has a pipe gun. He has a sniper. 18 range fucking reaches over the world. The crossbow, 15 range, so he can actually snipe, silent snipe people. And then we have our buff boy. Not a big difference. He has two molotovs. I guess that's the big difference. This guy has a smoke grenade and a hand grenade. Boom. Also, he has, of course, Skull Splitter. I love it. The Skull Splitter ability is super useful when you need to, like, you really need to do some real damage. But yeah. Current character, Dux, Bormin. So, we are going to continue down into Hammond's cabin. So let's go.
Thanks for signing me up back there, you crazy pig. Yes, Mr. Elder. Sign us up for a suicide mission, Mr. Elder. Did you forget there's like a kajillion ghouls out here who want to kill us?
Nobody gets to kill you but me now. Shut the duck up and keep moving.
I'm telling you, Bormin, ain't no happy ending in this story.
Stalkers don't get happy endings. We get each other. So watch my back.
I don't remember where we found the... Oh, the enemies are over here, right? So we want to go and explore over here to begin with. The Ark outskirts are over there. What the fuck? That's a lot of bones. That's some enemies. Ooh! Okay, these guys... Oh, fuck me. Oh, fuck me. This is bad. Okay. Okay. Activate Dux. He has the pipe gun. I could do a skull splitter. I will probably be able to kill this one this turn. I can shoot it with Dux. Then I can... run with Bormir, do the run and gun kind of thing, and just kill this one. I just hope it's just these two, because otherwise I might be screwed. Okay. Let's do it, Skull Splitter. Fuck up that stone dog.
Hi there.
Boom. Critical, it's burning. No shit! The enemy heard me. Oh no. Oh no, it hasn't... Oh god, I used it last fight. Well, these guys aren't ranged, and he's gonna have to charge if I run over here. So, I think I can run over here, kill it, and then that one isn't gonna reach me this turn. That's the play here. Let's go. Let's go, Bormir. Fuck you, dog. Oof, there we go.
Sweet takedown.
So, still got the dog coming in from behind. Okay, yeah, as I thought, won't be able to get any damage through, so we can just shotgun this boy, boom, go to hell, and we still have two shots left in this baby, 100%, it's dead.
Serves you right, you
boom! Ah, oh, that was some good fighting. GG, my boys.
Hey, follow me.
Hand grenade. Oh yeah. Common scrap. There has to be more stuff here, right?
These abandoned campsites always get my feathers twitching. Hundreds of them out here. All full of ghosts, shivering in the cold.
Oh my god, there's so much stuff here. I just love it. So I think I actually came in from a good angle on those dogs. I gotta say. Obviously, the skeletons being here so as to warn you, like, okay, there's something dangerous up ahead. Should probably be careful. Did not notice. Well, I did notice, but I didn't care. Okay? I didn't get it. So, my run with these guys this time, it is so much better. And, we're kitted. Shouldn't have a problem killing these guys.
We should check Hammond's cabin like the Elder asked us to.
What is this place? Okay, so I can't leave because I still have a quest in here. What the fuck is that? What is that?
Oh, whoa, check this thing out. It must have crashed. Look at this symbol on the side. It's like a star.
That is super cool. That's a massive robot. I do not want to face one of those robots at any point in this game. That's a lot of scraps. How hasn't Hammond taken these? Like, he has a cabin right next to this place. Fucking him being a stalker. He's shit at it, apparently. I have to gather all the scraps. Okay, so we should be getting up to the point where this... Yeah, this is where the bullshit happens. We got him hiding there. We know that there's gonna be people coming from behind. So I kind of want to move around over
That's
here.
That's it. Hammond's cabin. Let me guess.
Oh, okay.
That's
I can't
not
get around
Hammond inside. Him. Ghouls.
Can these guys just move? I don't want to fight both of them at the same time. Okay, I'm gonna scout around. I'm gonna leave Dux there. I'm gonna scout around over here. It might be better to actually go from this angle.
We chase everything, but there are no secrets. Where are the secrets?
The ones in the north will catch Hammond and squeeze the secrets from his head.
Oh, that's unlike.
Hammond tells us what the junk is for.
The junk is for us. All of it.
Okay, the Marauder's moving. So he left the shaman to his own devices right there. So we can hide over here. Try to do kind of the same thing as last time, except this time I ain't gonna fuck it up. I think that's a good idea. So let's get into some ambushing here. Oh my god, I'm about to sneeze. Okay. I think obviously we do Dux first. Yeah, but like, hitting with both these weapons is gonna fuck him up royally anyway, so let's do it. We need to kill this shaman because he's the one that summons the others with his fucking horn on the back. So
now it's getting
boom.
Fun.
6 damage. Okay. Okay. No fucking shit. Okay. Bormir. You have one job. You have one fucking job. Let's go. If you miss this, we're screwed. Just so you know. 100% he can't miss. Boom. There we go. No reinforcements for you, boys. Okay, so they sprinted with both their actions. So we're gonna move up here. Yeah. Moving up here. Getting some cover. And then we're gonna fire off a proper bullet. This goes. Boom. And he flies out of cover. Oh my god, this is perfect. This is the best. Jesus, man. And the difference is in this, you don't have to... Like, I can move here and shoot. Since this is like kind of a sniper, I don't have to use my full action to shoot it like in XCOM 2. So let's do that like that to get 100% hit chance, and boom! Fuck him up.
Serves you right.
Yes. Oh. Oh yeah, because he has one armor. Let's reload. And fire off. Boom. Handled. That was so much smoother. I took one damage on the boar, and that's his job. A far looker. This tube-like object gives its user the ability to view distant objects up close. Might also come in handy as a weapon if you get in a tight spot. Oh my god. Oh, one additional critical damage, 20% chance to disable robotic enemies? Damn! Enclave power brick, which when equipped will give a chance of the weapon emitting electrical projectiles. These can be used to do additional damage to mechanical enemies. To be honest, I thought it would just give me like a flat damage like bonus against robots. Like that would make sense. Okay, pile of notes. Let's see what this says.
Zone ghouls stripped this cabin clean. Almost everything useful was gone. But it's a good thing ghouls can't read. They ignored the diary hidden inside Hammond's desk. Me and Dux aren't big readers either. But we look for answers in the diary. And all we get is more questions. Hammond writes how he found the crash machine near his cabin. He's convinced the machine was sent as a message from a mythical place beyond the zone called Eden. Where everybody's happy and safe. When Hammond sees another machine fall north of here, he takes his stalker crew up there to find it.
Oh, fuck.
I close the diary. Here's the problem. Eden's a fairy tale. Some bedtime story mutants believe in, so they can get to sleep at night. So either Hammond is onto something, or his brain's got the rot, and he's about to kill a bunch of good stalkers. Guess we gotta find out. Me and Dux have to go north. Farther from home than we've ever been. It's dangerous. Dux thinks I'm crazy to press on. I don't disagree with him.
Well, that got intense.
I don't care about some stupid Eden. But we need to find Hammond. And if he's going north, we're going north.
If he's going north, that makes him a grade-A certified loony. No one goes up there, Bormin. And what's with those two stalkers he took with him? They should know better.
They're following orders, just like us. The Ark can't run without Hammond, so we're bringing him back. Especially with ghoul packs coming this far south. Wonder what they're planning.
Ghouls are too dumb to plan. Someone's pushing them down here. I'm feeling in my feathers.
Zone dog camp. As the seasons pass, I'm forced further out into the zone to find even the most basic of objects. From time to time, I stumble across the odd hidden place, even in locations I imagine were already cleaned out by stalkers seasons ago. One such place is to be found due west to the fallen machine. There appears to be remains of an ancient camp, complete with transportable hut. The location is currently home to a pack of zone dogs, who for some reason tolerate my presence near to their breeding grounds. They pick off wandering ghouls and I leave them alone. This unusual symbiosis works for me quite well. Okay, so I already killed those. So that's good. I've actually leveled up like 2 times already. So close to getting those moth wings. I could get another health boost. But do I want the hog rush instead or the Joker? The Joker is kinda good for like taunting. Though I'm not sure how useful it will be. He only gets health increases, man. Like, he's gonna be super slow in the end game. Dux is gonna be insane. Like, his movement speed is gonna be insane. +2 movement range is so good, though. Like, the thing is, like, it's strange. I feel like Bormir should have the movement range, because he's, like, this close combat shotgun kind of guy. And you always want to get close with those guys. Like, you want to get to, like, 1 or 2... squares away so that you can get 100% hit chance, but yeah, I guess that would make him way too strong. I guess the hog rushes might go that. But let's continue onward. We'll save the points. Because I really want the moth wings on ducks. That seems like such a cool upgrade, man. I just love the idea of just being able to fly up into the air and then like landing on top of a roof and just shooting with this pipe gun. Okay, so we are going. Oh my god, are we going? What the fuck? No. Hell no. House of Bones? Where the fuck are we going? I don't want to go over there. Don't make me do it. Oh, is that a crashed helicopter? Hmm. Interesting. I really like the way this game plays as well. I thought it would be like kind of in XCOM where it's kind of jumpy, like you like jump between these different battles and things like this, but it's actually like quite open. Zone before.
Bet you a picture of grog there's ghouls out here. They're everywhere.
These guys are quite paranoid. For good reason, but still paranoid. Okay. Let's see if we can find some nice scraps. Oh yeah. We are gonna be so fucking, like, kitted when we come back. Oh my god. The amount of scrap. It's too damn high!
Look alive. We got company. Wait. That's a stalker. One of Hammond's.
Oh, this is where we meet the third character. We get our third crew member.
Stay right there. Who are you?
You're Selma, right? You're a mutant like us, on Hammond's team.
Do I owe you money?
No.
Did I kill your brother?
No.
And Selma I am. Who are you?
I'm Dux, and he's Bormin. Hello? Like the only walking duck and boar in the whole lot? Come on.
That's funny. I think you've mistaken me for someone who gives a duck. I've got to catch up to Hammond before it's too late.
You're part of Hammond's crew. How did you get separated?
It was weird. We were all hearing strange voices, not from the zone, in our heads. And that's when the ghouls ambushed us. After the fight, I was somehow blinded, paralyzed. I could barely move. I told Hammond I'd catch up to him when it wore off. Two long, rough days. But I'm better now. He headed up north to a crash site to find some metal ship. Says it was sent from...
Eden, I know. Do you believe him?
If Hammond thinks there's an Eden, there's an Eden. Believe me. You guys are trying to find him too? And we can work together.
This is insane. You want to go more north? Into Ghoul Central? They'll kill us.
A lot of ghouls have tried to kill me, but I'm still here. So, am I part of your team or what?
Hell yeah. Third member, Selma joined your expedition. Let's see, what's her thing then? She has 7 points? Jesus. Oh, she has like extended throw range. She also can get run and gun. Super tendons. Reach high places by simply move. Oh, she can like jump super high. Oh, that is so cool. Joker, she also has the... I think she can be like kind of tanky. Tree hugger, disables enemies. I thought she was supposed to be the one that has like the... Like, stone skin kind of thing. Is that like one of her legs? Tree hugger. I'm assuming I just make like plants come out of the ground and just bind enemies. I thought she was gonna be the... Oh well, Super Tendons is actually sick. If she... Like, what weapons does she have? Oh, she... She has a fucking ancient pistol? That is like a legit pistol. That is a good weapon. She's gonna get the shotgun though. I probably should make that her first weapon, actually. There we go. So we got the shotgun as first weapon. Ancient pistol as her silenced weapon. I love it that it has a silencer. That is so cool. I love it. Let's see. Let's give it her hand grenade as well. Might as well, right? No items available. Do we want the super... I kind of want her to take the Joker trait. How much health? She has 6 health. Oh my god, no, Bormir is gonna... Yeah, she isn't gonna be tanking. She gets super tendons. And yeah, let's get the tree hugger. The tree hugger ability. Seek. Okay. So, we got three members now, so we should be expecting harder fights. More enemies in fights, at least. That's what we should expect. Oh my god, there's people all up there. Okay.
Look at this. Some sort of path through the forest. Hard to notice.
Ting buddy. Where the fuck are we going? Oh god damn, that looks bad. Oh my Jesus fucking Christ, we are not going into there. Are we? I kinda want to. Yeah, fuck it. Zone dogs. Yeah. So we got one dog there. There has to be more.
Wow. You can have one hell of a flea market with this junk.
Ah, looting through the walls.
Where do you think they come from?
Ah, fuck me. This is bad. This is real bad. So, we got one sunload there. We haven't been spotted yet, so... we could try and do a silent kill. I'm thinking, though, how much damage do we have? This is a 4. If we do the skull splitter and with Selma... she has her ancient pistol. Oh my god, it's not reloaded. How is it not reloaded? Okay. Okay. We got this. We got this. So we do the skull splitter on this one. Wait, that's not enough damage, I don't think. Oh, wait, no. No, it only crits for 5. Fuck me. We could still kill it. It's possible, but it's still... like, oh my god. Okay. Selma, what is your critical chance? 25%! There is actually kind of a high chance of us killing it. So, let's do it like this. I think we take a shot with her first. Yeah, we take a shot with her first. If she crits, we do another crit and we should kill the zone dog. Crit, 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 crit. Fuck me. She did not crit. Okay, so then we're gonna have to do the good old pipe gun, just to get 100% kill rate on this. Boom, there we
Bingo.
Go.
And that is that.
Now the other dog's gonna be coming at us, I'm expecting. Okay. And my boy can sprint up to here. Get some cover. Yep, there's the second zone dog. Okay, duck. You got this.
Oh, boom. Does that hurt?
Okay. So, how is it looking for her? She can, like, go up over here to get 100% hit chance. I think we still have one more dog. Somewhere around here, though. So we're gonna move up here. And fuck this dog up. Boom.
I owe you a grog. That was amazing.
Okay. As I said, there should still be a one dog left. It went this way, right? I'm sure there was another dog here. Or... maybe not. Oh well. Let's get going. Electronics. Ooh, that's a lot of scraps. Let's open this chest. What we got? What we got? Oh my god, we have a... oh my god, that's a... oh my god, that's an awesome hat. Okay. Okay, boy. I know you love your fucking sassy visor. Added to weapon range. I'm thinking we do the top hat. Because look, 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 look. Your weapons still have an amazing range. You don't need that buff. You, on the other hand, could use that. Like 16 in range on a pistol, that is insane.